वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल माय डियर फ्रेंड्स. अबाउट माय सेल्फ, आई एम डॉक्टर सुनील बपरोजन जी, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री इन जे एम पटेल कॉलेज भंडार. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट द सिंगल बीम ईवी विजिबल स्पेक्ट्रोफोटोमीटर. दिस इज अ डिजिटल ईवी विजिबल सिंगल बीम स्पेक्ट्रोफोटोमीटर. नाउ बिफोर एनी केमिकल एनालिसिस, स्विच ऑन द इंस्ट्रूमेंट एंड वार्म अप टू अबाउट हाफ एन आवर, देन स्टार्ट द केमिकल एनालिसिस. दिस स्पेक्ट्रोफोटोमीटर मेजर्स द ट्रांसमिटेड रेडिएशन, दैट इज द ट्रांसमिटेड मोनोक्रोमेटिक रेडिएशन फ्रॉम द कलर्ड सैम्पल. दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट फॉलोज द बीयर लैम्बर्ट्स लॉ. बीयर लैम्बर्ट्स लॉ इज अ फंडामेंटल लॉ विच गवर्निंग अ एब्सॉर्बेंस ऑफ मोनोक्रोमेटिक रेडिएशन. Measurement of absorbance of monochromatic radiation by transparent homogeneous system. On the basis of these laws, technique employed or used for measurements by instruments called as spectrophotometry. This spectrophotometer having, this is the wavelength knob. Here is this lead for the sample compartment chamber or cuvette chamber. Here is the information shows which for the filter selection. Filter number 1, 3, 5, these are filters for dark. This filter number shows here, this is the rotating filter wheel. This filter wheel is rotating towards the to and fro movement. This is one, then two. Second filter for the wavelength 340 to 390 nanometer. Again, filter number 3 for dark. Then filter number 4 for 390 to 630 nanometer. And again, filter number 5 for dark. And filter number 6 for above 600. 30 nanometers wavelength. These say filter numbers we can also called, it is a cutoff filter. And this two slots for the cuvette, and light is traveled from this direction here. Then this is the LED display which shows the operating information. This is the reference key. This is the mode key for changing this percentage transmittance mode, absorbance mode, concentration mode, and finally K. Then this knob for set value. This is the upward arrow shows the increasing the value. This is downward arrow shows the decreasing value. And then enter key. And here is the on off key. This is the knob for push, pull and push for the cuvette. Before any chemical analysis, we have to make its a solution. These are the solutions prepared for the analysis. The solvent used for the preparation of solution can be treated as a reference solvent. For example, this potassium permanganate solution, that is analyte solution, is prepared by dissolving appropriate weight of potassium permanganate powder as a solute, and it dissolved with the help of water and diluted up to the mark with water. Therefore, water is used as a reference solvent. This is the cuvette for which is used for the analysis. These are the glass cuvettes, and here in this cuvette there is a two surfaces. This is the transparent surface and this is the rough surface. We can hold it towards the rough surface. Now starting the experiment, we can fill the cuvette with reference solvent and place it to the reference solvent cuvette chamber and close the lid. Now again we can fill the sample solution in another cuvette. After filling the cuvette, clean the surface of the cuvette, hold towards the rough surface. Clean the cuvette and clean the cuvette with the help of tissue paper and place it to the cuvette chamber in sample compartment. Now we have to set filter number 4 for the 390 to 630 nanometer wavelength range. Now we are going to scan at 500 nanometers wavelength. Therefore, we can make a table for the recording absorbance. First for serial number, second for wavelength in nanometer, and third column for absorbance. Now we are starting scanning at 500 nanometer wavelength. At 10 nanometers bandwidth, we can take reading. Now press reference key. The display shows 0. Set the filter position 1, 3 or 5, that is dark. Then close the lid. Press reference key again. Display blinks calibration CAL. This CAL indicates calibration. This is the short form for the. And finally display shows the reference REF. Then press mode key and select the cutoff filter. It means we can analyze at 500 nanometer. Therefore, we have to select filter number 4 and then now again press reference. The display blinks CAL message, that is the calibration, and finally display shows 100% transmittance. Then change the mode, that is the absorbance 0 absorbance. Now pull out this knob for the absorbance. This is the absorbance of the sample at 500 nanometer. So record the absorbance 0.291. Then push the knob. Select the filter wavelength at increasing level order. At we can now fix it 510 nanometer and press the reference key. Then change the filter wheel for dark. Again press reference. Display blinks calibration and finally display shows reference. Then press mode and again press reference. Now select the cutoff filter and press reference key. The LED will show the calibration message and finally it shows 0 absorbance. Then pull out the sample knob and record the absorbance and at 510 nanometer the absorbance was near about 0.320. Then push the knob, select the wavelength by using wavelength knob, press reference key, it will show 0, then set dark filter. After selecting dark filter, again press reference key, display blinks calibration, and finally display shows reference. Calibration procedure is going on. Then press mode and select the cutoff filter, that is 4 number filter, and press reference. The display blinks with calibration CAL message, and finally display shows 0 absorbance. Then pull out the sample and record the absorbance, and at 520 nanometer it is a 0.360 absorbance. Then again push the sample knob, select the wavelength at 530 nanometer, then press reference key, display shows 0, set the filter, that is the for dark, then again press reference key, display blinks calibration, and finally display shows reference, that is REF. Then press mode key and set the filter wheel to choose the order of cutoff filter for 530 nanometer, that is 4 number, and close the lid and again press reference key. Display shows calibration message, and now it will get the absorbance 0. Then pull out the sample knob for the measurement of absorbance, and at 530 nanometer the absorbance is 0.338. repeat the same procedure for the scanning for the different wavelength. I have done scanning of the sample from 500 nanometer to 560 nanometer, and we are getting the absorbance from 0.29 to 0.260. Now we have to draw graph absorbance against wavelength, absorbance on the y-axis and wavelength on the x-axis. This is x-axis, this is y-axis, here is the origin. We are scan wavelength from 500 nanometer. Absorbance 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 and 0.4. Now we have to draw the plot, and we can get the outline of the graph is maximum wavelength at 520 nanometer, and this is the lambda max graph. The maximum wavelengths, maximum absorbance at wavelength, that is the 520 nanometer. Now fix this wavelength at 520 nanometer and take the absorbance of different concentration samples solution. Now we have to set the lambda max value, that is 520 nanometer wavelength, by using this wavelength. Now then we have to press reference key. The display shows 0. Set the filter position at dark filter and press reference key again. Display blinks calibration message and finally display shows reference. Then press mode key and then select the cutoff filter, that is filter number 4, by rotating filter wheel, and again press reference. The display blinks with calibration message and finally display shows 100% transmittance. Now press the mode key for absorbance. There is 0 absorbance. Then pull out the sample knob and record the absorbance of the first sample, that is 0.358 at, please show here, 0.358 at 0.001 concentration, molar concentration. Then now remove the sample cuvette and place it towards the sample solution flask and then clean the cuvette with the help of distilled water and rinse the cuvette with distilled water. And fill the solution, that is the second concentration solutions. Fill the cuvette and clean the surface of the cuvette with the help of tissue paper and place it to the sample cuvette chamber. There is do not change the wavelength knob. Here directly we can get an absorbance and at second concentration it is near about 0.720. then repeat the same procedure for all samples. I have carried out all the scanning of different concentrations sample and we got this absorbance. Now we have to plot a graph of absorbance against concentration. Here is a first is 0.0001 concentration, then second 0.0002, then 0.003, then 0.004, and then 0.005, and at the same time absorbance 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. Similarly we can take it towards up to 1.4, and first absorbance shows 0.358 at 0.0001 concentration and it is here. Then second 0.720 absorbance shows second concentrations, it is near about here. Then third and fourth. Now we can plot a straight line passing through the origin. Now we have to find out the unknown concentration of the sample, and absorbance of the unknown concentration is samples is 0.825, and it is near about here. Then you can draw the line in this on the x-axis and find out the unknown sample's concentration. By this way you can use this single beam spectrophotometer for the chemical analysis. Thank you.
On the behalf of Department of Chemistry, I am very much thankful to DBT Star College Scheme, Department of Biotechnology, Government of India, and I am also thankful to Coordinator DBT Star College Scheme and Principal of our J.M. Patel Arts, Commerce and Science College, Bhandara. Once again, I thank you.